plastic has only been around for 100 years. So in this 100 years, we've managed to make this mess where the ocean is almost seems so full that it's throwing plastic back out at us on the beach. Well, it's such an amazing material. It's so durable, it's so persistent, it can last for potentially hundreds, thousands of years. Once it's in the natural environment, that means it's not going to break down and it'll just keep accumulating. And it's making our oceans into a big plastic soup. So what we need to do is we need to turn off the tap. We need to stop making as much unnecessary plastic as we do and start treating it as gold, as this wonder material that we can keep using again and again and again. Within the Sea to Source project, it was looking at how a major river system can potentially be a conveyor belt for plastic going out to sea. So I've best been called as a plastic detective. So my role within the team, the Sea to Source team, was to investigate plastic in the air, in the water, and in the sediment. It can be really interesting and confusing to know that plastic can get into our environment in loads of ways that we wouldn't always typically consider. So the first research piece that I did looked at microbeads in cosmetics. Now, microbeads are tiny plastic particles that were put into our facial scrubs to act as exfoliants, so to help get the dead skin cells off to make our skin feel nice and smooth. But no one knew how many microbeads could be in one bottle of facial scrub. So I was in the lab for hours and hours extracting all of these tiny microbeads, and we found that 3 million could be in one bottle. So in a squirt on your hand, there could be over 10,000 that you're washing your face with. They go down the drain, potentially through the sewage treatment works, and then into our ocean. So it really opened my eyes that plastic is everywhere and in some sources that we wouldn't always typically consider. Dress is actually made out of plastic. I've got my plastic phone next to me, a plastic water bottle. So it's really revolutionized our lives in loads of wonderful ways. But the problem is single-use plastic, when it's this persistent material that can last for thousands of years, but I'm only using it for a matter of minutes. So my own lifestyle, and it can be difficult sometimes, but just try and minimize the amount of single-use plastic that you take and that you need. Sometimes it's impossible and you might need it, but with the help from industry and government to give us those choices, hopefully in the next few years, it should and should be made easier. Little changes can make a huge difference. So, for example, if you're going to the supermarket and buying a facial scrub, just make sure on the ingredients list that it doesn't contain microplastics by looking for polyethylene. That'll just take a few seconds from your day. If you see some litter on the floor and it's safe to do so, pick it up and put it in the bin. Wash your clothes only when you need to stop tiny microfibers potentially entering the washing system and then going into our ocean. So value the power that you have in your individual actions.